Are you setting up a channel for the first time and want to know all the YouTube channel settings and channel options that are available to you? This video shows you all the channel features that most guides miss off, and by the end of the video, you will be able to progress your YouTube channel knowing everything is optimized and set correctly for your needs. And if you're jumping into this video right now, then it's actually part of a playlist on how to set up your YouTube channel from scratch, which I will link in the description below for you. Now let's head over to the computer and find out those channel settings. Head up to your icon in the top right hand corner and then click into YouTube Studio and click on Settings. Now this screen will be quite familiar for you. We have covered certain aspects of this already in previous videos in this playlist. And this video will now cover all of the bits that we haven't covered previously. So the first one is on the General tab, and then the default currency that you want to use on your channel. Now, as you start, this doesn't matter too much, but later on, as you've grown your channel, you'll want this set to the default currency that you want to have on your channel. For me, I'm English, so I'm going to change mine to GBP, which is the British pound. You select your currency there, and then when you click save, it will automatically close the box and you'll see your settings have saved. Now, to stop that box from disappearing each time, I'm going to come back into the settings, but I won't click save until the very end of what we're doing today. So the next one on the list is channel. Come over to your channel and under basic info, select your country of residence. Again, this will be unique for you and your channel, but I'm in the UK, so I'm going to scroll down and find United Kingdom. Now, your keywords down here, this is in conjunction with your description, and the things that you have written in your description should match some of your keywords that you're creating on your channel. So these keywords should be things that you're going to be talking about regularly. So for Ultimate Gamer, so I've just pasted quite a lot of keywords in. As you can see, you have 500 characters to use, and I've tried to use as many as I possibly can. This is really to help show YouTube what your channel is about. So the more specific you can be here, the better. But really, as you can see, I've put indie games reviews, best indie game reviews, indie gaming, top indie gaming. It's all fairly similar stuff, indie game PC. So by doing this, YouTube now gets an indication as to where and what videos are going to be on this channel, and that can help them filter the search and show my videos to the correct people. As a quick side note, the keywords are not as important as they used to be, but still add them in and help YouTube, because every little helps. And if YouTube needs to look at these for any reason, then they now know exactly what your channel is about. Now head over into advanced settings, and your options down here are asking whether your channel is made for kids or not. Now, in most cases, you'll be able to select either yes, this is made for kids, or no, it isn't. But you can also select that you want to review this for every video. Now, let's just clarify exactly what this means. Made for kids means that it's made for young kids under the age of 13. So if you're a channel like Cocomelon, you would say, yes, this is made for kids. Otherwise, if it's a gaming channel like mine, although the games may be suitable, it's not made for kids, it's just suitable for kids. So if that's the case, you would select no, set this channel is not made for kids. Alternatively, if you do have some videos that are made for kids and others that aren't, you'll have to select which ones are and aren't on every single video that you upload. I would suggest, where possible, sticking away from this option, because you can always forget and it's something else to do every single time that you upload a video. As we scroll down slightly, you've got the Google Ads linking account. You can link your account together, so then you can get some more insights into what your ads are doing. I'm not actually going to link a Google Ads account here, but this is exactly where you would come to do it. I wouldn't worry if you're a new channel creating an ad account. It's probably not going to be something that's overly relevant for you unless you're a big business and you're planning on doing ads to promote your videos. So automatic captions are added to every single video that you upload by YouTube.
You don't get the option to turn this off. It's an accessibility feature that really helps a lot of people otherwise unable to watch YouTube videos. However, as YouTube say down here, it sometimes makes mistakes, so you can tick this box to stop any swear words or bad words being potentially shown to those viewers. I personally would suggest ticking this. However, if you are regularly swearing and that's part of your show or your personality, then you may want to keep this off when they're watching with accessibility features turned on. Coming down to subscriber count, you can opt to either show or hide the number of subscribers your channel has. Now, I would always recommend having this turned on so people can see how many subscribers you've got. You'll find that some people hunt for channels that are small and some people hunt for channels that are large. And if you hide this, then they have no way of telling which size channel you are. Now, over time, it becomes quite obvious anyway with the production level, etc. However, it also looks like you've got maybe something to hide if you're hiding your subscriber count, and being transparent and open to all of your subscribers and potential visitors is usually a good thing. So my advice is to leave it turned on so people can see who is subscribed, but it is your choice at the end of the day, so don't feel pressured either way. Moving further down to the advertisements. Now, advertisements will turn on and be on your channel regardless of your channel size and if you're making any money from ads. What this does is it disables the interest-based ads. Now, what that means is that personalized ads will not be shown on your channel. Generally speaking, that means fewer ads can be targeted towards your viewers. Now, that may be helpful if you wanted to minimize the amount of advertising that your viewers see. However, it will also mean that you don't make as much money when you do hit that monetization milestone. My personal recommendation is to leave this as is. It's generally recognized on YouTube now that you're going to get adverts unless you pay for premium. If you pay for premium, then you won't see any of these adverts anyway, and viewers have made that choice rather than you as a channel. And finally, moving down to clips. Clips are sections of your video that can be taken and pasted into social media and shared among other people. So it's not easy to take a clip and then use it in your own video. It's mainly just so if there's a particularly important part of your video, then someone can take that clip and just share it among their friends or other people that may be interested. Personally, I recommend keeping clips on. It's not an overly popular feature that people use very often. However, if you do find someone that knows how to use it and you've got clips turned on, then it can only add views to your channel if they use that and other people see it via their shares on social media. Now, the very final thing down here is you've got your manage YouTube account and remove YouTube content. So if you click on to manage your YouTube account, it actually takes you to another page where you can manage your people that have access to your channel and a few other advanced settings as well. We're not going to go into details on this video. However, just be aware that this is where it exists and this is how you would get to it. Now, the last thing on this tab should already be completed. If you haven't, then I suggest going over the series so you can get back to all these features and how you enable them. And that is all of the basic and advanced settings for your YouTube channel. Now, there are some other settings to go over. However, before you finish, make sure you click save, and now all of those settings are saved to your YouTube channel. In the very next video, we'll go over the uploading defaults, which will save you loads of time when you come to uploading videos. I hope this video has been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one.